So if I was to give you a challenge and you only had a few minutes to speak to a new agent and you had a vested interest, so you wanted this person to succeed, what's the key advice that you would give them?
I'd want them to know that the business statistically will spit them out, most of them. And I think a lot of new people coming into the industry are at least aware of that. I hear and see teachers telling people more in that phase three or during the time in which they have some schooling. I know a lot of it's online now. They are using the language that, you know, be prepared to have a lot of money for the 6 months. Be prepared to not make it in this business. It's almost like, and I talk to new young agents coming in the business because we recruit them for our team. And a lot of them are scared. They are scared. They know that statistically the odds are against them, without question. So I think the biggest thing would be to take away that fear, because if that's your mindset coming in, you could potentially continue down that path, because the brain tends to take us where we believe, right?
And what we hear, so although they're
Absolutely.
saying that to students, it's good to have a reality check, but then it's also not good to have a reality check.
Exactly. You're almost better to just be like I was in 1989, believing that I'm going to be the best, and this is naive, and it's going to be amazing. I came in the business, and literally the next week, the market dropped. We went into a recession, but I learned through that recession. A lot of people dropped out of the business then as well. But I think what I would say to them is try to latch on to a team that's productive, that can provide qualified leads and the proper training to understand the language early on that gives you the credibility that you can leverage not only from the team, but to have the right language to convert those opportunities. It's really about numbers. If you can do those numbers early on, you'll get some traction and your belief system will be that you're in the right place.
It will stay with it.
Absolutely.
Very true.
So that's tough. That's harder to do today than ever as an individual. So my belief is, and I'm not just saying this because I have a team, my belief is that if you can leverage all of those things somewhere, and the only place I can see it is a successful team, then do it. And now, if a team is run properly and efficiently, and it can provide those new people with a platform that's better than any traditional real estate brokerage offers, why wouldn't you stay on a team? That's not to say teams don't work in brokerages, because they do. As a matter of fact, brokers are endorsing teams now, and they're happy to have them because they're recognizing that a lot of the brokerage growth comes from a great team leader that has a foundation that's fantastic for people to work on, recruiting new people, and the brokerage grows as well.